I was a wandering soul, traveling a well.
Who is Pastor Mark?
Our pastor.
What does he do?
He teaches us.
What does he teach you about?
Jesus.
Jesus?
Our teacher. Number one.
What is your favorite thing about Pastor Mark?
He's a good preacher.
What's your favorite memory about Pastor Mark?
Whenever he said that he was loved to jump up and down inside an elevator, because it made me laugh.
Who does Pastor Mark remind you of?
He reminds me of Abby. He reminds me of my papa.
Who does he remind you of? Does he remind you of anybody like a cartoon character? Who? Which one? Who? Oh, he reminds you of your mommy? Okay. What is your favorite thing that he does?
Makes me laugh and makes me giggle a very lot.
What does he do when he's not here at church?
He's
going to bed.
Going to
bed? Yeah.
Fishing a lot.
Fishes all the time?
Stays home and reads his Bible. Last thing he prays.
What's your favorite thing about Pastor Mark? What's your favorite thing? Handshake.
And I pray the whole world hears the cry of my heart.
I want to thank you, Pastor Mark, for being a very genuine and sincere person. I've never been to a church where my pastor actually cries, which is a good thing, even though you're a man. I like it. It shows me that you're sincere and you're true and that you truly care about us as members, and it means a lot to me.
I'm thankful for the spiritual leader that you've been in my life and how you've always been there during the toughest times of my life. You've never given up on me or my family, and I'm just extremely thankful for that. I love you, Pastor Mark.
I want to thank Pastor Mark for telling everyone about the gospel. I want to thank Mark for being so kind and loving.
I want to thank Pastor Mark for being the best father-in-law I've ever had. No, seriously, I want to thank Pastor Mark for all he does for our family personally and for the church family in general. He has no idea what impact he's had on how many people he's had an impact on.
I would just like to thank Pastor Mark for always being there whenever I needed him. Anytime he called, he would always come to the house and be there for me.
Showing my scars and telling my story of how much
What does Pastor Mark mean to you?
He means everything to me. He's loyal, he's honest, he's a good person. He's funny, he's witty, he's got good wisdom, he's got good character. He's the best all the way around. I vote for him for Pastor Appreciation any day.
What do you want to thank Pastor Mark for?
For being a great preacher. I want to thank Pastor Mark for teaching us about Jesus.
Well, I'd like to say that I am so thankful for Pastor Mark because he is truthful. He gives everything he has to the church. He is very knowledgeable, but he puts it to you like you can really understand it. And he is always there for everybody. A lot of times he's there for everybody when he is really tired or sick or whatever. So him giving over and above means more to me that he knows. But also he's one of our very best friends. And I love you, Mark. Thanks very much for all you do.
Gifton, what do you want to thank Pastor Mark for?
For helping, leading me to the one that I got saved this year. Down upward falling, spirit soaring, I touched the sky when my knees hit the ground.
So what does Mark mean to me for Pastor Appreciation Day? I tell you, he means the world to me. I love him to death. I just thank him for his, I love the way his heart is for God and how he just, the desire he has just to do God's will. I love it. I just want to thank him for his service. I love Mark, and I love you, Mark. I want to tell you I love you, and I thank you for your service for this church and for the community around us and everybody. I've seen it spill out in a lot of other people besides just here at this church, and I look up to you, and I thank you, and I love you so much.
Pastor Mark means to me a friend that I can go to no matter what's going on in my life. He will not be judgmental, and he will always direct me to the truth of the Word. I thank you for that.
Okay, Pastor Appreciation. I want to say first that I appreciate Pastor Mark and the stand that he takes in his personal life. He is who he is everywhere that he goes, wherever you see him. I'm so grateful that I have a pastor that lets the Holy Spirit lead him, and he reads my mail often, and I'm so thankful for it. And I'm thankful for his family, and I'm thankful to God that he accepts us for who we are, and he's always got a smile on his face when we come in, and know that he loves you and he's glad that you're here.
Hey, I just want to thank Pastor Mark for just being the awesome pastor leader that this church needs. I also want to thank him for just helping raise me up in this church, going all the way back to when I helped him lead choir in this sanctuary, actually. And just that small token, I guess you could say, or that small gesture has helped me become the man of God that I am today. And it's been a pleasure, Mark, and I love you. I'm really good.
Pastor Mark for all that he is and for leading his church and for being true to himself. He means a lot to our family, and especially for little Mason. Mason, every time we drive by their house, he says, "There's Mark and Donna's house," and we love him, and I know that he loves our family, and I just thank him for all that he does.
Hey, Dad, just want to say thanks for being an incredible pastor, but even more than that, I want to thank you for being an awesome dad to me, and also an awesome papa to my girls. And it's just an incredible experience to be your son, and I love you with all my heart.
I appreciate Pastor Mark. Every Sunday morning he gets up there, and he's led by the Holy Spirit, and he's not ashamed of it, and I just really appreciate that, just always being submissive to what the Lord's leading you to do.
Hey, Pastor Mark, I just want to thank you for everything that you do. You're always there, you're always loving, and you're always kind, and you're an awesome pastor. We love you.
I'm thankful for my pastor because of the example he sets. You can just watch him, and I mean, it's goals. It's what I want to strive to be, and if God ever puts me in that position. And I'm just thankful for that example that he sets. It's a great one, and I'm very thankful for him for that.
I just want to thank Mark for being genuine and being authentic. He and Chad and I have taken several trips together. And the same man that stands before us on Sunday mornings, the same man that if we're talking around through the woods in the middle of the night, or if we're somewhere in another state, he's the same man that stands before us on Sunday morning. I want to thank him for that. And I want to thank him for personally for encouraging me to keep going when the time I felt like I was giving up. But he's always been an encouragement and a help, and I know that I can go to him if I need anything. I just want to, Mark, I want to thank you for that.
I'm thankful for Pastor Mark because he's just so good to everybody. You know, he's got so many of us to be good to. But I just hope he stays around forever and ever and ever. But I got a bone to pick with him. Now he got up in front of the congregation and accused me and poor Gladys of doing his door up there at Pigeon Forge. So I just figure after an accusation like that, he owes me an apology like that. So I'm going to wait for that.
I'm thankful for Pastor Mark because he's more than just a pastor to me. He's a friend, he's a mentor, and he's probably the most genuine person I've ever met. He really lives when he preaches, and he's very supportive. And he really just loves his congregation. So, I love you, Pastor Mark.
We were sitting around trying to put this video together. We were looking at some songs, and one of them was, we really liked the lyrics that went, we thought along this. One of them was Loving My Jesus, and it made me think about you, Mark, because you're always happy, and you can tell the love you have for Christ. You don't even have to, just being around, you don't even have to say it, and I want to be like that. That means so much to me. And the other song was I Touch the Sky, and the lyrics in it talk about, you know, when my knees hit the ground, I touch the sky. And it's really talking, you know, if you think about it, I mean, what we think is impossible is possible through Christ. And you remind us of that often. I just want to say thank you for pouring into me for all these years and how you pour into the church too. We love you so much. Thank you, Mark. You have called me deeper.